It's AumSum time!
What if tea disappeared?
No problem. I love my orange juice.
Oh, AumSum.
To buy this t-shirt, visit AumSum.com.
Firstly, if tea disappeared, tea lovers would be one sad lot. Secondly, it is believed that tea was invented in China. If tea disappeared, Chinese would be one sad lot. Thirdly, if tea disappeared, people who work in tea plantations would have to find a new job. Fourthly, if tea disappeared, popularity of coffee might skyrocket. Lastly, some people love to drink tea in the morning while reading newspapers. If tea disappeared, these people would be extremely disappointed. Why do our teeth turn yellow?
'Cause our teeth need some color in their lives.
Nah.
Our teeth basically consist of three parts. The outermost part is enamel. Enamel is white in color. Beneath the enamel, there is dentine. It is yellow in color. Then comes the part called pulp, which has blood vessels and nerves.
Is this the same pulp found in our fruit juices?
No. Please concentrate. When we drink or eat acidic fruits and beverages like lemon, orange juice, soft drinks, etc., they erode or wear away the enamel, exposing the yellow dentine and thus making teeth appear yellow. However, did you know that some people's teeth are naturally yellowish? This is because in such people, the layer of enamel is thin, causing the yellow color of the dentine to appear more clearly and thus making their teeth appear naturally yellow.
Why does February have 28 days?
Many centuries back, a Roman king called Numa made a calendar according to 12 lunar cycles, which approximately take 354 days. But as even numbers were considered unlucky, Numa rounded off days to 355. He also made each month odd-numbered, leaving one month, that is, February's, with 28 days to reach the total of 355. But as the Earth takes 365.24 days to travel around the Sun, seasons and weather conditions started mismatching with the 355-day calendar. Then came Julius Caesar, who decided to follow the solar calendar of the Egyptians that had Januarius and Februarius in the beginning. He made the calendar into 365 days by adding days in each month except February, as still, 0.24 days were pending each year. After every 4 years, he added one day to February, making it a leap year. Thus, February has 28 days except during leap year. Why do we see only one side of the moon?
'Cause the other side is shy.
Nah. Our moon takes about 27 days to rotate around its own axis and 27.3 days to revolve around the Earth. This means the moon rotates around its axis at almost the same rate or speed as it revolves around the Earth. Hence, the same side of the moon is constantly facing the Earth, making us see only one or same side of the moon. However, if the moon did not rotate on its axis, then we could see the other side of the moon. We would also see the other side if the moon rotated in 13.5 days. That is, it made two rotations in one revolution, but this is not the case. However, an interesting fact is that due to the elliptical orbit of the moon, we can see almost 59% of the moon's surface. Why do we breathe through one nostril?
No idea.
Our nostrils have specialized tissues. At a given time, these tissues are swollen in one nostril while they are shrunk in the other. Hence, when we breathe, air passes easily through the nostril in which the tissues are shrunk. However, due to the swelling, very less amount of air slowly passes through the other nostril. Thus, it seems as if we are breathing through one nostril only. However, after some time, the swelling and shrinking in the nostrils reverses. This breathing pattern is called nasal cycle. Nasal cycle is beneficial for us.
But how?
Some odors are detected better in fast-moving air, while others in slow-moving air. Thus, with fast-moving air in one nostril and slow-moving air in the other, our nose can detect a greater range of smells. Besides this, our nostrils are moist. Continuous breathing can make them dry. Hence, when we breathe through one nostril, the other nostril gets time to become moist again. What are tonsil stones?
They are special stones used to make bowling balls.
No. When we open our mouth wide enough and look at ourselves in a mirror, we can see a pair of palatine tonsils in our throat. These tonsils have crevices and holes called tonsillar crypts. Now, sometimes food particles, mucus, dead cells, and bacteria get collected in the crypts, and over time, the collected lumps begin to calcify.
What does calcify mean?
Wait, I'll explain. Calcification is the accumulation of calcium in a particular part of the body. Usually, this happens for the formation of bones and teeth. However, sometimes, the collected lumps in the crypts also start calcifying. They turn into hard structures of calcium and other compounds, thus forming tonsil stones or tonsillolits. Why is salt added to icy roads?
To make ice tasty!
Nah. Salt helps melt the ice and thus clear the roads.
What? But how, dude?
The freezing or melting point of water is about 0 degrees Celsius or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. When temperature drops below the melting point, water molecules bond together to form solid ice. However, when temperature rises above the melting point, the bonds break and the ice melts, forming liquid water. Now, when we add salt or sodium chloride to ice, it lowers the melting point, causing solid ice to melt and form liquid even at temperatures below 0 degrees Celsius. Then, the salt dissociates in the liquid water, forming sodium and chloride ions. These ions make it harder for liquid water molecules to again bond together and form ice. Hence, the melting ice does not refreeze and thus helps clear the roads. How does placebo effect work?
I don't know, dude.
All right, I'll explain. Placebo in Latin means I shall please, and this is what placebos do. Placebos are inactive sugar pills, injections, etc. that look like real medications or treatments. In most cases, they relieve pain and make us feel better, even though they are not actual medicines. This effect of placebos on our body is called the placebo effect. Now, one of the reasons why placebos are effective is that when we take them, our mind perceives placebos as real medications. Hence, our brain reacts to the placebo in a manner which is similar to when we take real medications. Thus, our brain releases natural painkillers like endorphins that help relieve pain. In addition to this, it also decreases the production of stress hormones, thus making us feel better. Why do birds need gravity to swallow food?
Maybe because they are fans of Newton.
No. When humans eat food, it enters into a muscular organ called food pipe or esophagus. In the esophagus, a series of contraction and relaxation takes place that pushes or moves food towards the stomach. This movement is called peristalsis.
Dude, why do you use such complicated names?
Oh, please listen. In most birds, such peristaltic movement doesn't take place in their esophagus. Hence, they need to depend on gravity to push their food through the esophagus. When a bird eats its food, the bird lifts or tilts its head up, and with the help of its tongue, it directs the food towards the throat. Then, the gravitational force of Earth causes the food to slide down into a pouch called crop, thus helping the bird to swallow its food. Why vultures don't get food poisoning?
'Cause they go to regular yoga practice.
Nah. Vultures are generally scavengers. They eat decaying or rotting flesh of dead animals. But any decaying substance has many harmful microbes which, if consumed, can make an animal or a human sick, or even cause food poisoning. However, vultures have a strong acid in their stomachs that protects them from harmful microbes.
But we also have acid in our stomachs, right?
Indeed. But the acid in a vulture's stomach is much stronger than the acid in a human's stomach. It is so strong that the acid can even corrode certain metals. Thus, when a vulture eats decaying or rotting flesh, the strong acid in its stomach destroys most of the microbes that can cause food poisoning and other health problems, thus keeping the vulture safe.